don't care what they say. They can talk, they can hate. I don't care. Let them do what they do. I will still love you. Cause I will still love you. I will still love you. I don't care what they.
Hi everyone, this is Dwayne Dixon, the Hitman D-Dub. Today we'll be taking a look at how I prepare my DJ sets using the feature in Virtual DJ 8 called GeniousDJ. Okay, let me open up Virtual DJ 8. And since I don't have a controller, I need to change my audio settings. So therefore I can record the audio and record my screen capture at the same time. Since this February mix is going to be about love and relationships, let me go and type in the word love in the search engine and see what pops up. Okay, let me try this Faith Evans song, Love Like This. Once you pick a song, you can drag that song over to the GeniousDJ, which is located on the left-hand side of Virtual DJ. The GeniousDJ will come back with a list of songs that will work well with the song that you have picked. You'll see a list of songs that have a blue magnifying glass next to it. That means those songs are located within your music folder. A regular magnifying glass song just means that Virtual DJ has located that song on the internet or within your music library. I usually don't click on these songs. I pretty much stay with the blue magnifying glass songs because I know those songs I have in my music library. And the red magnifying glass song is the songs that you can find in Virtual DJ's Content Unlimited, which is a monthly subscription where you can download and stream songs from Virtual DJ's music library. Once you find a song that you like, just drag it over to the side list. Continue to drag songs that you like over to the GeniousDJ and see what songs will come back. Then once you find a new song, drag it over to your side list. Continue to do this until you receive all the songs that you want to use in your DJ set. Now in step two, I take all the songs that I had got from the GeniousDJ and I try to place them in the order that makes my mix flow better. First, I take a look at the beats per minute. I'll start with the lowest beat per minute and then gradually increase. Sometimes this works, then other times it doesn't. In this case, it didn't work. So I'm gonna go back and pick the first song that I started off with, which was Faith Evans' Love Like This. I'm going to take it and put it in deck one and let that play, and then find a song that I think will mix well into that song. It's usually a song that has a similar BPM or similar style. You see, I like the way Let's Get Married mixed into Love Like This. So once this plays out, I'll be looking for my third song, and again I'll be trying to find a song that's similar in style and also is similar in beats per minute. I try not to jump too high or too slow. And now I'll continue this process. Come to my last song, and then that'll be my DJ set. I I'm liking the way these songs are beat matching with me just using the mouse. So this should be real easy for me to do it when I plug in my controller. Once you get all the songs that you want to DJ with within your DJ set, in this step, you should go to YouTube to check to make sure that the songs that you want to DJ with and upload to YouTube within your video, you need to make sure that you can use those songs within your DJ mix. Because if you don't and you upload it to YouTube could block the audio to your video, and it'll just be your video playing, or it can just totally block the video, and then you can also get strikes. So this is how you can check to make sure that your DJ mix doesn't get flagged or they don't take it down or block the audio. First, you'll go to your YouTube channel profile page and click on Creator Studio and go to Create and click on Music Policies. Here you'll see a list of copyrighted songs, and you'll type in the song that you want to search for in the search box. And then once you find the song, click on it, and YouTube will tell you whether you can use that in your video or not. If YouTube says that you may use the copyrighted material in your YouTube video, then YouTube will place an ad on your video. The revenue received from the ad on your video will go to the artist for you using their song in your video. So it looks like I can use all the songs in my DJ set in my YouTube video. Now let's move on to the next step. In this step, I'll go back into Virtual DJ, select all the songs that I have in my side list, go over to playlist and right click on the word playlist, then select create new playlist, then name my new playlist. I'll name it the Funky Spot, since that's the name of my live stream that I'll be doing. Hit OK. Now before I go back, let me change the Beyonce song to red so I know that has some bad words in it. Alright, so I'll select all my songs again. Now I'll drag those songs into my new playlist folder, the Funky Spot, and now you see I have all my songs from my DJ set listed there. Now let's head over to the Virtual DJ folder within the Documents folder. Go down to Virtual DJ, click on that, then find the Playlist folder. Click on that and then find a playlist that you had created within Virtual DJ. Copy it. And then I'll go over to my music folder and paste my playlist, my Virtual DJ playlist, within my music playlist folder. So therefore, it's easier to find within Serato when I open that up. Okay. Now you can close Virtual DJ. Okay, now let's open up Serato DJ. Because once Serato DJ opens up, you'll go up to where it says File. Okay, you'll go up to where it says File. Go under the Music tab. Click where you have saved your playlist. And then drag the playlist to your crates, and your playlist will automatically turn into a new crate. Okay, let me plug in my controller. Now I have two decks. Okay, at this point, I will set cue points for each one of my songs, so I'll know where to start the song and where to exit for the next song. And then this is also a place where I practice my transitions between the two songs. Some of my songs already have cue points, so let me delete those. Okay, let me start this song. So now I'm trying to find a good place to mix in. Okay, I think I'll start it here. This is the chorus. Sorry, I didn't record the audio. So now I'm checking to see how long the introduction is for the second song. So I'll go back and put a cue point to where I need to start the second song. Okay, there's the downbeat to the chorus. So, and then I'll go back and rename my cue points. So I either would name the cue points either like verse, chorus, or bridge, or I give it a name to let me know what to do next. In this case, this would be the place where I start the second song. So I will play start song here at this cue point. Now the second song, the beginning of the MP3 isn't exactly where I want to start. So I'll go in a little ways, a few beats, and put a cue point there and rename it start here. Now I'm going to jump down a few ways. I have did this to a few songs already. Now I'm at the new edition song. I put my cue points to where I want to start and where I want to end. With this song, I'm not going to play the whole song. So what I would do is record a flip. And with flip, it'll let me record a remix. So it record all my cue jumps. So with this song, I'll play it from the beginning up until the green cue point, and I'm going to jump to the yellow cue point. So that whole section between the green and the yellow will be erased. So as you see, the song is playing. I'm getting ready to jump, do a cue jump. I It jumped. I'm gonna let the song play out. Okay. Now I'm gonna stop it and then I'm gonna save this flip. I'm gonna go into the flip section and give it a name. Okay, now I'm going to go back and play the flip. So I sped up the video so we can move on. And this is in flip mode. The song on the right. Now watch it automatically jump from the green to the yellow. Okay. So while it's doing that, I'm also checking to see how I want to bring in the next song. And also, I like to color code my songs. You know, with the red songs, are those are all the songs that have explicit lyrics in it. Also, if I record a flip to a song, I like to put a brown color marker next to the song to let me know that that's a flip, that's a remix. Therefore, I don't have to remember the remix. I can just hit the flip. And it'll automatically do it for me. And as you can see, I did all my songs. I got about, look like six flip songs. Okay, so that's how I create my DJ sets. I hope you enjoyed this video. So as usual, please like, subscribe, and leave a comment below. Also, you can find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Mixcloud at HitmanDDub. Take care and stay blessed.